What's up, my financial fit fam? Adam here, and welcome back as always. Today, we're going to continue our series, Follow the Smart Money. This is where we look at some of the greatest investors of our times and those of past generations, so that way you get to learn a little bit more about those that have really shaped the investment space, and who knows, you might learn some things along the way too. The three cornerstones that we're going to be looking at as part of this segment are going to be experience, strategy, and overall vision. So in today's video, we're gonna be examining someone from the newer school of investing. Some would say they're very outspoken, a real trailblazer, even a wildcat. So in today's video, we're gonna be looking at Chamath Palihapitiya. If you wanna learn more about some other prominent investors, click on the link above, or the link will also be in the description. We're going to be adding more bios on other investors just like this. Oh, where to start with Chamath? Well, first off, he was actually born in Sri Lanka, and then he moved with his family to Canada at the age of 6. After graduating from the University of Waterloo with a degree in electrical engineering, Chamath worked as a derivatives trader for the investment bank BMO Nesbitt Burns. Chamath then worked in a senior management position at AOL, Mayfield Fund, Winamp, and Spinner.com. Is it sad that I still remember my AOL Instant Messenger screen name? If you remember yours, drop it in the comments below. In 2007, Chamath joined Facebook, and that's probably what he's most known for. He was integral in growing that business up to 750 million active users. While working at Facebook, Chamath made some angel investments, including Palantir, Playdom, Pure Storage, and Bumptop. In 2011, he was like, yo, I'm gonna start my own thing, so he left Facebook, and he started his own venture capital firm called Social Capital. Over the next 4 years, he made several investments, including Yammer, Second Market, Gluco, Box, Slacks, and Premise. In that time, by 2015, they had over $1.1 billion in assets. In 2019, Social Capital head of Sophia was established. Now, this was a partnership between Chamath Palihapitiya, who was the founder and current managing partner of Social Capital, and the co-founder and CEO of Head of Sophia, Ian Osborne. Social Capital Head of Sophia is relevant because this is the company where all of Chamath's SPACs are coming from. This gives retail investors like you and I the opportunity to buy into a company at a fair value, unlike what we're seeing out of most of the IPOs these days. Let's take a look at what Chamath and Ian Osborne have put together as part of their investing strategy. Social Capital Head of Sophia Holdings unites technologists, entrepreneurs, and technology-oriented investors around a shared vision of identifying and investing in innovative and agile technology companies. We believe the future success of the capital markets for technology companies is dependent on new company formation, the sustainability of robust private market funding, and an increase in willingness of private technology companies to become publicly traded, and therefore become available to a broader universe of investors who can benefit from their disruption and growth. Our mission is to create an alternative path to a traditional IPO for disruptive and agile technology companies to achieve their long-term objective and overcome key deterrents to becoming public. This alternative IPO is called a SPAC, a special purpose acquisition company. Social Capital sells shares to the public market. It then seeks out a private company, merge with that private company, and the funds raised plus the shares that you own will now be associated with this newly traded public company. So simply put, the VC firms that used to invest in technology companies and then bring them to the public markets later on are now giving you an opportunity to invest earlier.
I think that SPACs are very much here to stay. Back in the, you know, using the language of inequality, it evens the playing field. It democratizes access to high growth companies. How? Because it allows retail and it allows long tail institutional investors, folks that may not have necessarily been tier one hedge funds, now they can also play.
Now, just because Chamath is raising money through Social Capital, it doesn't mean that he doesn't put in his own money either. He actually ties up $100 million into each of these deals. Chamath and Social Capital have established 6 SPACs so far. Some of them have already emerged and others have not. While still relatively young, Social Capital Sophia made a big splash in 2019 when it merged with Virgin Galactic, a British commercial spaceflight company which now trades under SPCE and was founded by Richard Branson. In December 2020, IPLB, another Social Capital SPAC, completed its merger with Opendoor. Opendoor focuses on streamlining buying and selling homes online. You can get an instant offer from Opendoor itself. There's no need to do any repairs because Opendoor will take care of all of it. You can move when it's convenient to you. You also save on closing fees and selling, and there's local support to handhold you through the entire process. The blending of a traditional experience plus technology to make a consumer's life easier. Next up is IPOC, which also just completed its merger in early 2021 with Clover Health. This one hasn't seen the same return just yet, but it has a high upside. Clover now trades under the ticker CLOV, and it's a way for people to add additional coverage to their traditional Medicare plan. It allows for zero or low premiums, low copays, and low prescription drug cost. Plus, there's a cap on the out-of-pocket expenses. IPOD, or iPod, has not found a merging target just yet. However, IPOE has announced that it will be merging with SoFi. Now, that merger hasn't yet been completed and probably won't be for the next couple of months. The last established SPAC, IPOF, similar to IPOD, does not have a merging target just yet. Now, as you can tell, we started with IPOA, but Chamath has locked up all the tickers from IPOA to IPOZ, which lends you to believe that there's probably 20 more or so on the way. Chamath and Social Capital are looking for technology-based, innovative, disruptive companies that are going to win. And his philosophy is, find the winner and buy it. Chamath is very active on Twitter, so follow him and follow me. And here you're gonna find some emotional outbursts, probably some funny memes, but even more interesting is his thesis on the companies that Social Capital will be merging with. This gives you an insight into his investing philosophy, and it's good just to understand the thought process of what investor is looking for. I had to throw this in there because he's a big believer in blockchain technology, and in particular, cryptocurrencies. In a recent interview, he asked which cryptocurrencies were going to be the big winner, and he was truly only convinced that at this point, it would be Bitcoin. As a disclaimer, I am invested in Virgin Galactic, Opendoor, Clover Health, IPOE. I don't have any IPOD or IPOF just yet, but I like the way Chamath and Social Capital think about investing. And as the kids would say, I'm here for it. Chamath is creating his own portfolio by looking for industry leaders and investing in those companies. Some have even touted him as the next Warren Buffett. And while he's been wildly successful in the SPAC space, only time will tell. And maybe ARK Invest and Cathie Wood will have something to say about that. As always, save, invest, and grow. Ciao, ciao.